Let's talk about the different ways that you can find errors in a trial balance. So when you're preparing a trial balance, your debits and credits need to equal. But what happens if they don't? Well, the first step, just add up the columns again. It might have just been a math error, and that can be an easy fix. If that doesn't work, see if the difference between your debits and credits is divisible by 2. And if it is, you'll look to see if a balance equal to half of the difference has been entered in the wrong column. If the difference between your debits and credits is divisible by 9, then we're going to look for a transposition error. And if the difference between your debits and credits is not divisible by 2 or 9, and it wasn't just a math error, then you have to go back to your ledger to see if you made a mistake there. So let's first just look at an example where you need just to add up the columns again, right? So we have our debits and we have our credits, and we add them up, and we get 54,000 as our credits, and total debits of 40,500. The first step, add them up again. Because if you add up your debits again here, you'll see that your debits end up being 54,000 as well. It might have just been an error in your math. You might have just plugged a number incorrectly into your calculator. So the first step is just add up your debits and add up your credits again. Now, let's say that didn't work. Well, then we can see, okay, is our difference divisible by 2? So in this example, our total debits are 51,000 and our total credits are 57,000. So we find the difference between those and we see it's 6,000. So the first step, is it divisible by 2? Yes. So we divide it by 2 and now we're looking for that 3,000. We're trying to see if that 3,000 is on the wrong side. Well, we can take a look here at our owner's drawings. And owner's drawings has a balance of 3,000, and we put it on the credit side here in this trial balance. However, assets, drawings, and expense accounts should all be debit balances. Liabilities, capital, and revenue accounts, those should be the ones over on the credit side. So if we move that 3,000 for owner's drawings to the debit side like it's supposed to, we see now that our debits and credits equal. Now what about if the difference is divisible by 9? So now our total debits are 90,000 and our total credits are 54,000. So we find the difference and we see it's 36,000. Now, 36,000 is also divisible by 2. So we would first divide it by 2, get that 18,000, but you'll notice there is not an 18,000 anywhere in our balances. So then we go on to see if our difference is divisible by 9, and 36,000 is divisible by 9. So then we're looking for a transposition error. That's where you flip around a couple numbers. So you would be going through your ledger and comparing it to all of the balances here on your trial balance. You would check the 20,000 for cash, the 5,000 for accounts receivable, to make sure that you wrote the numbers down correctly on your trial balance. And while you're doing that, you realize that equipment, you made a transposition error. In your ledger, it said 15,000. And on the trial balance, you put 51,000. So you flipped the 1 and the 5. So if we correct that, put the 15,000 in for equipment, you can see that your total debits and your total credits equal once again. Now, what happens if there wasn't just a math error in your trial balance and the difference is not divisible by 2 and it's not divisible by 9? Well, let's take a look at this example here. We take the difference between our total credits and our total debits, and we get 2,613. Well, that's not divisible by 2 and not divisible by 9. So what you have to end up doing is going back into your ledger and see if you made any mistakes there. Right? With cash, for example, you probably had multiple transactions dealing with cash in July. You might have incorrectly calculated the balance for cash. So you're going to be checking your ledger for mistakes in that scenario.